Well, hello, Harvest. My name is John Smith, and I'm the co-campus pastor here at our Rolling Meadows campus. Good to be able to spend a couple moments with you today. Well, as I look outside, it's beautiful, and it's been beautiful all week. And one of the things that has happened because of the weather getting so nice is that people are out and about more and more. And one of the things that I've observed is walking has taken on a whole new level. And there are people who begin early in the morning. There are other people who pick it up in the middle of the day. There's some people who go out at night and they walk. And you know, it's interesting. When you take a look, you can see some people, this is way new to them. This is something that was not a part of their life before COVID. They didn't do it. There's some people who, man, this has been a priority for quite some time. They've had a plan, they've had a purpose, and they've been after it, and they have some intentional goals laid out before them that they are set out to accomplish. And I think there's some things we can learn from them inside of that. And this term walking is something that's a biblical term. And I'd love for us to spend a couple moments in Ephesians chapter 4, verses 1 through 3, really talking about the walk in a manner worthy of the calling of which we've been called. There's one thing to walk every day outside. There's another thing to walk with the Lord in such a way that we represent Him in a worthy way. And so I'd love for us to take a moment in God's Word together. Let's find Ephesians 4, and I'll read verses 1 through 3. Why don't you follow along with me? Ephesians 4, I therefore, a prisoner for the Lord, urge you to walk in a manner worthy of the calling of which you have been called, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, eager to maintain the unity of the Spirit and the bond of peace. Well, just like people who are walking, they have different goals, they have different purposes. For some, it's they're getting ready to train for something, or they're getting ready to be a part of something, of an event, and so they're trying to lose some weight, or they're trying to just get in better shape. You know, for me, I've taken up walking in this season because what I saw was that I was putting on some weight and I needed to shed those pounds. And so taking up that challenge of my purpose is to lose some weight, so I'm going to walk every day. And then to hear the plan that has been laid out for all of us as a church to think about walking 8,000 steps a day. That doesn't happen for me early in the morning. It takes a little bit of time to get those 8,000 steps in, but it really helps us. It helps me in my plan and my purpose to lose some weight. And so a purpose behind walking, there's many reasons why people walk. But this passage has some purposes for us as believers to think about, so that we can walk in a manner that's worthy of the calling of which we've been called. And so as I read those verses, maybe something jumped out at you of being like, ooh, I'm going to take that one on as a purpose to grow in. There's four of them. And so why don't you just pick one of those out that would be something that you could go after for the rest of this week. So which one would it be? 1, 2, 3, or 4. Take a look. Walk in a manner worthy of the calling of which you've been called. Here's the first one, with all humility and gentleness. Is that maybe something you should set in your purpose wheel? With patience, is that something that you can improve on? Bearing with one another in love. Or is it number 4, eager to maintain the unity of the Spirit and the bond of peace? I find that inside of a purpose that we have, and I don't know which one you're going to pick to work on for the remainder of the days this week, but I want each one of us to grow in our purpose, because Satan is about how to defeat us from accomplishing that purpose. And so how do we go about defeating Satan? How do we go about making progress in our walk with the Lord? Well, I think it's we have to have a plan. And I find that spiritual disciplines are required for us to make our purpose a reality. And so I just want to challenge you that every day, if your purpose this week is to grow in humility and gentleness, if your purpose is to grow in patience, if your purpose is to grow in your unity and the spirit of the bond of peace, then spend some time in the Word of God searching out passages that will help you to be able to see how you can grow in that. Satan's already got a way to try to derail you from your purpose. He uses all sorts of things that are before us every day. Some things, like social media or the news, it can be something that just set us off and we want to respond in our human thinking and with our own opinions, and we have some things that we'd like other people to know what we, you know what? Take a breath, ask the Lord to meet you in this battle to represent Him well. Walk in a manner worthy of the calling of which you've been called. You're an ambassador. You're a representative of Jesus Christ. You're a representative of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and we get a chance to walk in a manner worthy of the calling of which we've been called. We get to display these fruits that show that we have embraced a purpose, we're going after it, and we're getting our plan together every day in the Word, growing in our understanding of how we can be better at these things and representing Jesus. You know, some of the attack might come from inside our home. The ones that we love the most, we might be wrestling with in some of these fruits. We might be wrestling in our patience. We might be wrestling in maintaining unity in the spirit of the bond of peace. And so maybe you're taking on this, like, I need to represent Jesus better in my home, with my wife, with my children. I need to represent him in a better way with the neighbors that I'm with on a given day, or my coworkers, that they might see these fruits, that they might see the purpose and who's behind what these purposes are about. It's Jesus. Walk in a manner worthy of the calling of which you've been called. It needs to be a priority. So when you pick on one of these fruits that you really want to focus on for the remainder of the days, realize that there's testings that are coming, and there's that are outside of who we are, and there's also going to be testings from inside. Just like the person who's going out to walk, it's easy when it's sunny, but when it rains or when it's cold, it's a lot harder to get up and get out. And so there's going to be some internal challenges. Oh, I just want to sleep in. You know what? I'll read later. I'll spend some time in prayer later. And then later never comes. And so our purpose to grow in one of these areas needs to have a plan that's going to be high on our priority list in order for us to see the Lord do some great work in our walk. Walk in a manner that's worthy of the calling of which we've been called. If we know Jesus and we call upon Jesus, He's going to meet us right where we're at, because He wants us to make progress in our walk with Him. He wants us to grow in our relationship with Him. And you say, well, I've been walking with the Lord for a while, and I feel like in this season, I've plateaued. And you know, that happens even sometimes to athletes. They plateau, and they seem to be doing the same thing time and again. They can't get to the other side of it. They can't improve on their time. They can't improve on their cadence. They can't make some improvements. You know, a coach will tell them, you need to change it up. You need to make some, you need to change your disciplines just a little bit. Maybe it's interval training. Instead of just running at the same pace, we're going to have you sprint for a period of time. And then we're going to have you run uphills. And then we're going to have you run downhills. And then for running and for walking, to improve, you've got to change it up a little bit. And you know, in our walk with the Lord, there's some disciplines that we know that we're supposed to be a part of, but maybe we need to look at them a little differently. Maybe we can increase the fervency of our prayer. Maybe we can, instead of just spending some time praying silently, maybe it's we pray our prayers out loud. Maybe it's we write our prayers down. Maybe it's we go into our proverbial prayer closet and just pour ourselves out before the Lord by laying on the floor and out before the Lord. Lord, and you plead before Him. Maybe it's in the way that we enter into fasting. We've never done that before, but maybe that's a way that the Lord will increase His intensity in helping us to understand how we can see accomplishment, how we can see progress, how can we grow in these fruits of humility and patience and gentleness and maintaining unity in the spirit of the bond of peace. Well, I don't know which one you're going to go after this week. But I would challenge you to think about walking in a manner worthy of the calling of which you've been called, and figure out which one of these you would love to represent the Lord in a greater way, and then just get after it with your plan, make it a priority, and just ask the Lord to help you make the progress. So have a great rest of your week. Enjoy being about the work of the Lord. You are loved.